Good afternoon, children. Today, let us start the class with the chapter Polymers. It is from your part 2 chemistry. The weightage of this chapter is around 3 marks. The word polymer is a Greek word which is comprised of two terms, poly and mer. Poly means many and mer means units. That means polymer is a substance which is made of many units. Or polymers are defined as substances which have high molecular mass that's about 10 raised to 3 to 10 raised to 7 U and formed of simple molecules called monomers through chemical bond. Is it clear what are polymers? They are substances which have high molecular mass of about 10 raised to 3 to 10 raised to 7 U and are formed by the combination of simple molecules called monomers through chemical bonds. In short, we can say that polymers are macromolecules. That is, they are complex molecules. That is, but is there any difference between polymers and macromolecules, or are they the same? No, they are not the same. There is some difference between polymers and macromolecules. Polymers are always made of simple molecules called monomers. Molecules called monomers. In every polymer, we can see a collection of monomers. For example, consider the formation of polyethylene, which is actually formed by the combination of monomer ethene. When several molecules of ethene combine together, it results in the formation of polyethylene, which is a polymer. That is, in this case, ethene is the monomer and polyethylene is the polymer. So we have proved that polymers are complex molecules of monomers. But on the other hand, you consider macromolecule. For example, we can say chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, the molecular formula is C55H77O5. N4Mg. Just say it is also a complex molecule, but it is not made of so many simple molecules. It itself is a complex molecule. That is the main difference between polymers and macromolecules. In polymers, we can see the presence of monomers, but macromolecule itself is a complex molecule. That means all polymers are macromolecules, but macromolecules are not polymers. Is it clear, children? Okay, now let us continue with the chapter, that is classification of polymers. We can classify polymers on different bases. The first classification, let us study on the basis of source of origin. On the basis of source of origin, we can classify polymers into three groups. The first one, we can consider it as natural polymers. As the term indicates, natural polymers means polymers which are obtained from nature, that is from plants as well as animals. For example, you consider cellulose, gum, gelatin, etc. are examples of natural polymers. The second group is synthetic or artificial polymers. Polymers which can be synthesized in the lab, that is man-made polymers, are termed as synthetic polymers. Example, we can consider it as PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride, PAN, that is PAN, polyacrylonitrile, or nylon 6, etc. And the third group of polymer is semi-synthetic polymer. Semi-synthetic polymers means here also the base is a natural polymer which undergoes synthesis in lab. That is, for example, you consider cellulose diacetate, which is formed by the polymerization of cellulose and acetic anhydride. That is, cellulose undergoes acylation and results in the formation of cellulose diacetate, which is a semi-synthetic polymer. Second one, we can consider vulcanized rubber, which is formed by the combination of vulcanization of rubber. That is about the first type of classification. So on the basis of origin, we classify polymers into three: natural, synthetic, and semi-synthetic. Okay, now let us study second type of classification, that is on the basis of structure. On the basis of structure, again we can classify polymers into three. First one is termed as linear polymers. As the term indicates, this polymers combine together to form long chain, long thread-like structures. Long thread-like structures are termed as linear polymers. Just see, you can see that due to this particular structure, they are able to pack very close to one another. So they possesses high tensile strength, and high melting and boiling point. Okay, children, that is, here we can say that the polymers combine together to form long thread-like structures. Due to this particular structure, they can be packed very close to one another. So they possess high density, high tensile strength, and high melting and boiling point. Let us consider the example as HDP, that is high density polyethylene and polystyrene. High density polyethylene can be prepared by the polymerization of N molecules of ethene at a temperature of about 333 to 343 Kelvin, 6 to 7 atmospheric pressure, in presence of a mixture of catalyst triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride to get HDP, that is high density polyethylene. This mixture of catalyst triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride is termed as Ziegler-Natta catalyst. This is very important topic. It can be asked for 1 mark. Ziegler-Natta catalyst is a mixture of triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, which is used for the manufacture of HDP, that is high density polyethylene. N molecules of ethene undergoes polymerization at a temperature of 333 to 343 Kelvin and 6 to 7 atmosphere in presence of Ziegler-Natta catalyst and results in the formation of HDP. Is it clear? Now, second type we can consider it as branch chain polymer. In this case also, polymers combine together to form long chain, but we can see the presence of branches in between. Due to this branches, we cannot pack them so close to one another. So they have low density, low tensile strength, and low melting and boiling point. Example, we can consider it as low density polythene, that is LDP, as well as we can consider glycogen as some of the example for branch chain polymer. If you consider LDP, in order to prepare it, N molecules of ethene undergoes polymerization at a temperature of about 350 to 570 Kelvin and a pressure of about 1000 to 2000 atmospheric pressure in presence of traces of oxygen. Then we will get LDP, that is low density polythene. Is it clear? So these two are examples for branch chain polymer. Now the third type of classification is, that is, I mean third type of polymer is network polymer. In this case, the polymer chains combine to form three-dimensional network. They form three-dimensional network. As a result of this three-dimensional structure, they are generally rigid and hard. Example, we can consider Bakelite, melamine, formaldehyde, etc. Is it clear, children? So today we have just studied about two types of classification of polymers, that is on the basis of source of origin and on the basis of structure. So today you revise this topic and let us have the rest classification tomorrow. Thank you.